In this video, we're going to give you a quick introduction on encoding NFC tags with an Android phone. We're going to use an NTAG213 NFC tag and NXP's Tag Writer app to encode a web address. We will do this in three stages. The first stage is to encode the link. Second stage, we will check what we have encoded. And on the third stage, we will lock the tags. So first, open Tag Writer and select Write Tags, select New Dataset, and then Link. On the screen here, you'll see an option to add a description. You don't need to, and we'd recommend that you don't. Then, you need to select URI type. In the dropdown, you'll see a number of choices. So let's pause here and have a look at these. When a web link, such as seratag.com, is encoded onto an NFC tag, it can be encoded either with a URI identifier or without. If we were to encode this link with an identifier, we would encode the data, known as the URI field, as seratag.com and set the URI identifier as https://. However, we can also encode the link simply as https://seratag.com without a specific URI identifier. Any mobile reading these links will, in the first case, join the identifier and the data together to make the link, and in the second case, just take the link. The end result is the same, but the main difference is that if you encode with an identifier, you will save valuable memory space. The data space required for no identifier is 1 byte. It's also 1 byte to set the identifier, which means that you could save up to 12 bytes of memory by using it. On a smaller memory tag, such as the NTAG 210 micro, that might make quite a difference. So we're going to select https://. And then enter our URI data as seratag.com. We then click Save and Write and continue to the next screen. Now there's a few options on this screen, so we'll pause and briefly cover them. Write multiple tags simply means that you can encode the single URL that you entered onto as many tags as you like. Useful if you're going to be encoding a batch of 20 or 30 tags, for example. It will only encode the same URL, so if you want different data on each tag, then this software can do that, but we'll need to explain that in another video. The next option is protection. This allows you to lock the tag at the same time as encoding, but for the moment, we'll leave that off and we'll explain locking later. Confirm overwrite just adds another screen, making sure that you want to encode. We'll uncheck that because we know what we're doing. Leave interaction counter and launch application off. Now click write and hold your phone over the tag. The tag will encode and it will show the new content of the tag. So now we will check what we encoded. We select Read Tags, hold the phone over the tag. You should see the URL that you encoded, and you can tap the link to make sure it follows where you want it to. Now we want to lock the tag. Let's pause here and we'll cover locking. Locking means that the data cannot be changed on the tag. Simple rule is this. Locked means that nobody can change the data, even you. Unlocked means that anyone can change the data. If you are going to put the tags in a public space, lock your tags. On this software, there's also soft protection and the ability to use password protection, which is a feature built into the NTAG 213 chip. Ignore soft protection and we'll leave password protections for another day. So now we're going to lock our tags. We select Protect Tags, then Lock Tags. Hold the phone over the tag, and we're done. And that's it. We've encoded a web link onto an NFC tag, checked it, and locked it. Thanks for watching.